morning from AdAlta is Tim Oldham. Tim, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to be speaking, Tim. Look, your June quarterly updates out this week. Firstly, the preclinical program here for AD-214. How's that going?
We're really pleased with the progress we've made on inhaled AD-214 in the last quarter. We have a number of exciting and pivotal results reading out in the next 3 months or so. All of those experiments are now underway, and we're starting to see the data coming from those. So very happy so far. You know, remembering that what we're trying to prove is that we can get AD-214 into the far reaches of the airways of the lungs to treat lung fibrosis, that once it's there, it can be effective. So we've got three sets of studies running there, and they're all underway, and we're looking forward to the results imminently.
How's the partnering interest across some of these indications?
So we had a really good meeting series at the Bio International Convention in San Diego in the back half of June. Really pleased to confirm interest, not just in the lead indication, IPF, pulmonary fibrosis, but also interest across the two other indications where we have some really good encouraging preclinical data in both eye fibrosis and kidney fibrosis. And all three of those indications are $1 billion potential indications. So what we learned was that, yes, there is continued interest from big pharma and big biotech companies in, you know, all, in new antifibrotics, that there is interest across all three indications, and that each company has slightly different interests and priorities because they're all geared around, you know, typically around organ systems, their respiratory or their kidney or their eye. And so what that does is not just encourage us that the asset is valuable, but it also encourages us that we could potentially partner this asset multiple times for multiple indications. And so as a result of that interest, we have been able to realign our manufacturing and toxicology campaigns so that we have the flexibility as the data reads out over the next 2 to 3 months for the inhaled formulation and for some eye fibrosis data coming from our collaborators at Uni Melbourne, to make sure that that next manufacturing and tox campaign is geared to the indication or indications that we're most likely to be able to partner. And those conversations we expect to ramp up towards the end of the year. So really valuable to get close to the market and be able to fine tune the really expensive parts of the next part of our campaign as we run into next clinical trials.
What about the immuno-oncology programs?
So building on the back of the success of our collaboration with Karina Biotech, and we're starting to see the first cell killing data from our first target with Karina reading out at the moment. So we're looking forward to being able to talk more about that very soon. But on the back of that collaboration, we launched a new business development campaign at Bio and also with our business development agents in China to look at other biotech companies where our iBodies could help them expand their immuno-oncology programs, their CAR T and their CAR NK programs. And we've been really pleased with the reception that that's had. There's only so many targets that we can develop with Karina. And so being able to expand the capability and the capacity to help other cell-based immunotherapies against other targets is really exciting. That got a lot of interest. People see the value of these small format antibodies like iBodies in adding value to those therapies and making them more efficient. And so, yeah, we're very excited about the potential of that particular part of our business right now.
And at the end of June, a strong cash balance here, $8.7 million. Remind us near term, Tim, what your milestones are, what your priorities are.
So in the next 3 months, we've got data reading out for inhaled AD-214 on deposition, distribution, and efficacy. We have data reading out on eye fibrosis with AD-214 through our collaborations in the University of Melbourne. And we'll finalise the formulation for inhaled AD-214. That'll then lead us into further discussions and accelerating our partnering discussions through the second half of the second quarter of the year, running into December, and that'll enable us to then fine-tune exactly what we trigger manufacturing and tox for in the first half of 2023.
Good to speak, Tim. Thanks for your time.
Andrew, thanks for having me again.